I grew up answering to the nickname of Randy, and hence the title of my story. It's simply Amos 8, Randy. I grew up in Grand Rapids, Michigan, which is so close to Canada, they call it the Great White North, and it gets very, very cold in the winter. Because they're on the opposite end of the same time zone, where it gets dark in the cold winter at 5:30 or 6 here in Michigan, that means it gets dark at 4:30 or 5 at night, again, because it's the same time zone. I was on my way to my friend Kurt's house in the darkness, but it was really quite light because there was a full moon and it was clear as ever. And I'm walking through the snow through the field. It's about 3 city blocks to Kurt's house from back door to back door. And on my way there, it is so cold that the snow crunches under your feet. And the moon was so bright that the snow, it was like diamonds on a pile of sugar. It just glistened. It was beautiful. And as I'm walking to Kurt's house, I'm 2/3 the way there and I hear Amos. Now, Amos is a golden retriever, about 80 pounds, friendliest dog in the universe. And he was out and about. He's not supposed to be out and about. Whoever would grab Amos by the collar and walk him home would always get a free handful of candy from Mrs. Van Winkelstein, Kurt's mother. I was happy. I hadn't had any candy in a while. So I'm like, here, boy. I walk over to Amos and I reach out and I take him by the collar. I'm like, come on, let's go. And we start walking 4 or 5 steps. I'm just so happy with anticipation. I'm going to get some candy. And just like that, blink of an eye, it all turns to shrieks of terror. Amos whipped his head to the left. He knew exactly where my hand was because I was holding onto his collar. I was wearing thick leather mittens that had a wonderful nylon lining. And he bit. And he sank his teeth through the leather, through the nylon, through my skin, through the muscle, right to the bone. And you would think he had a hold of an old sock. He was growling and swinging his head back and forth, my arms going this way and that way. He was playing. I wasn't. The pain started in my hand. It went right up my arm, through my chest, and it came out my mouth and my eyes. I screamed. Tears are coming down. I'm screaming. I'm doing everything I can to get him to let go. And he does. And I take a breath, but in the spirit of Cujo, Amos came at me again. I put my arm up and he latches on. I think the doctors counted 20 puncture marks through 2 shirts and a heavy jacket. I have no memory of exactly what happened after that. I know he let go. I don't know if I kicked him. I don't know if I pushed him away. I walked the 100 yards up the hill to Kurt's house. I knocked on the door just like I would if I was waiting for him to answer, and Mrs. Van Winkelstein answered. I whimpered. Amos bit me. She didn't hesitate. Well, then get inside here. And she takes off my mitten and she turns on the water and sticks my hand in the sink. And the water, it washes away all the blood and you can see the bone. I don't want to look anymore. So I don't. She pulls out a bottle of methylate, that red stuff. She pours it on it. I'm in shock. I feel nothing. She bandages up my hand. She calls my father. I walk out to the car, go to the hospital. The doctors couldn't sew it up because it was a dog bite. They just wrapped it up. And as I reflect on the story, God, this was 1978. You do the math. All I can think of was, I didn't get any candy.